Okay, so in this lecture we are going to discuss about solving homogeneous recurrence relations. So we will solve the first problem now. So solve an equal to an minus 1 plus 6 an minus 2, where the initial conditions are a naught is equal to 3 and a1 is equal to 6. So we want to find the recurrence, we want to solve the recurrence relation, means we want to find the formula for an. So what we will assume is that we'll say let an be equal to r raised to n be the solution c1 r raised to n, or first let me write r raised to n. Okay, let an be equal to r raised to n be the solution of this recurrence relation. I will substitute this an equal to r power n. This is the initial guess, and that we are going to substitute in the given recurrence relation. So what is the recurrence relation? Let me write it: an equal to an minus 1 plus 6 times an minus 2. So when I substitute it in this recurrence relation, I'm going to get r raised to n is equal to r raised to n minus 1 plus 6 r raised to n minus 2. So the lowest power here, the lowest power is of r raised to n minus 2. So I will divide that lowest power by this lowest power to the entire equation, so that r raised to n divided by r raised to n minus 2 is equal to r raised to n minus 1 upon r raised to n minus 2 plus 6 r raised to n minus 2 upon r raised to n minus 2. So the, when I do this here on the left hand side, I will be left with only r square, because n minus 2 powers will cancel and I will get r square. In on the right hand side first term, the n minus 2 powers will cancel and you will be just left with one power of r. So it will be just r, and this r raised to n minus 2 r raised to n minus 2 directly cancel, and I get this quadratic equation. So I will transfer all the terms on one side and I will get r square minus r minus 6 is equal to 0. And the factorization of minus 6 for minus r will be minus 3 and plus 2. So this will become r minus 3 into r plus 2 is equal to how much? Is equal to 0. So when I write the roots will be r is equal to 3 and r is equal to minus 2. So these are the two values of r. But what was our initial solution an? The initial solution an was r raised to n. So here we get two values of an. So an has two choices. It is either 3 raised to n because r is 3, and in the second case the value of r is minus 2. So then an can also be how much? Minus 2 raised to n. So we have two solutions now, and therefore we will take a linear combination, and that linear combination we will assume to be the general solution. So this means an, the general solution an, we will write it as c1 into the first solution plus c2 into the plus c2 multiplied by the second solution. We write it in this fashion. Okay, c1 into first solution and c2. So this will be c1 into 3 raised to n and c2 into minus 2 raised to n. So this is the most general form of the solution. And now we will find out the values of constant c1 and c2 using the initial conditions. Now what are the initial conditions? Let us write down. So the first initial condition is a naught equal to 3, I suppose. So put n equal to 0 in this above equation. So when you put n equal to 0 here, you will get a naught is equal to c1 into 3 raised to 0 plus c1 into minus 2 raised to 0. So this 3 raised to 0 and minus 2 raised to 0, they will become 1 directly, because anything real number raised to 0 is 1, non-zero real number. So plus this will become c2. And a naught is how much? And a naught is 3. So this is the first equation that I got from n equal to 0. Now I will put the value of n equal to 1. And I will get a1 is equal to 3 times c1 minus 2 times c2. So what is the value of a1 given to us in the problem? The value of a1 is given to be 6. So this will be 6 equal to 3 c1 minus 2 c2. So this is the second equation. Now I will solve the first and the second equation. Solve equation 1 and equation 2 simultaneously, and I will get the values of what? I will get the values of c1 and c2. So c1 plus c2 is 3, and the second equation is 3 c1 minus 2 c2 is equal to 6. So when I multiply the first equation by 2, I'm going to get 2 c1 plus 2 c2 is equal to 6, is equal to 6, and the second equation I will write below it, which is 3 c1 minus 2 c2 also equal to 6. So that this will cancel when I add them, and I will get 5 c1 is equal to 12, and therefore c1 will become 12 by 5. This will be the value of c1, but I know that c1 plus c2 from equation first, c1 plus c2 is 3, so this means c2 is equal to 3 minus c1, but c1 is 12 by 5, which is 15 minus 12 is 3 upon 5. So this will become 3 by 5. So C2 is 3 by 5. And therefore, the solution of the recurrence relation AN, which is C1 into 3 raised to N plus C2 into minus 2 raised to N, right? And the value of C1 is 12 by 5. So AN is how much? 12 by 5 into 3 raised to n plus 3 by 5 into minus 2 raised to n. This becomes the solution of the given recurrence relation.